Ladies and gentlemen, So all of a sudden, the game just froze and kicked me straight off and stopped the broadcast and everything else. So we're going to hop back in here. We're going to go from exactly where we were. I'm going to upload both halves. Well, really, both. I don't know. We'll see, but either way, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to let it go and we will resume this game. Not quite sure what happened, but we'll carry on. Thanks for joining us, and I hope you enjoy.
First down here. Split backfield here. Handoff made. Thomas there to make the tackle. Imposing their will early on the defense with a solid effort on the ground.
Well, we talk so much, don't we, about the passing game in the NFL, but it's still about who can out-hit the other one. And right now, the offense, they are winning that battle. Nice run.
Second and four following the run. Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch. Lynch is tackled down.
Lynch is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Offense lines up here. The Dolphins take it from the 33. Tackles made, and that'll move the chains.
The Dolphins are great at managing a football game. They know the situation here. It's a short yardage situation, so don't try to do anything fancy. Just run it up in there with power and get the first down.
And he hauls it in. That'll stop the play right there.
Nice catch by the receiver, but it still doesn't get a first down.
Lynch is lined up directly behind the quarterback here. The Dolphins take it from the 28. Lynch is tackled down at the 24.
When you're an offensive lineman and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards, you are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying, we're tougher than you are, and we're just going to come right at you.
And a gain of four.
Even though the defense knows you're probably going to run the football, it's third and short. If you run hard, all you need is a little bit of a lane. We see it there, able to get the first down.
First and 10. They'll go ground. Middle. And that gains one.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stop him for a short game.
The play clock's running down. Middle. As good as it gets. Touchdown.
That touchdown and putting them ahead. And when you get ahead in the football game, the National Football League, it makes you relax and you play better.
Dolphins for the extra point. And the extra point, the kick is good. The Bills are ready to return the kickoff. The touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. First down here. Griffin's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. Ellington's handed the football. Ellington is tackled down. That leads us to second down. Going to take the handoff now. He's taken down at the 23.
Well, I know it's not going to make a highlight film, but still a good solid run up in there for a couple yards.
Offense lines up here. Third and 7. He's got the catch. Now They take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Running backs are such a big part of the pass game now in the NFL. Look at this play, able to take a short catch and get a long gain out of it. Nice job by the running back.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Davis brought down after picking up only a yard. One quarter complete, and we'll take a break as you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Ellington is in the backfield. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Well, we still got a close game here, and you got to try to keep it that way. It's third long, and you lose the football game. Don't take a chance on the offensive side. Wait for your next opportunity.
The Dolphins come out in a dime package. Third down and 12. The defense gets the sack.
Well, that time the quarterback is sacked on the third down, and that's, of course, that's bad. But the good thing is, he did not try to force the football down the field and get the turnover.
The call on Weatherford for the punt. Offense now coming out. Now first and 10. Lynch. Running room. McCarroll takes him down.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
He's brought down at the 23-yard line.
Lynch is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
And he's tackled at the 30-yard line. The Dolphins have fallen back on what they do quite well, and that's run the football. Lynch is near the top of the league in rush yards, and he's showing why today.
It is hard in the NFL to run the football like this every single week, but here we are again, and they are getting it done.
The Dolphins will take the snap from the 30. They get to him just in time, 1 yard shy of the first down.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
On this passing down, the defense comes out in the nickel. The Dolphins from the 32. Lynch looking out wide. And he is brought down at the 39.
Well, everybody talks about the pass in the NFL. When it's third and short, you got to man up and be tough and strong. Nice job that time by the offensive line. They let the running back get in there and pick up the first down.
He's taken down at the 47. And here we have second down. Offense lines up here. Play clock's running down. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it.
Good run that time. It results in a first down, and it moves those chains on the sideline. Keep those chains moving. Tire that defense out.
Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch. That picks up seven. Phil, today we've seen a running back who was putting up some big rushing totals.
Jim, sometimes I get tired of talking about the quarterbacks and wide receivers, how well they're doing. What a good change of pace to watch the game evolve around a running back. And, man, this guy is taking advantage of those opportunities.
And he's able to get out to the 34-yard line.
Lynch is a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
The Dolphins have it at the 34. Carnes still got it on the play action. Incomplete. This will be second down. What a drive this has been. Lynch has got it on the handoff. He's tackled at the 30.
Good job that time by the offense. Power run gets him a few yards.
We've hit the two-minute warning here in the first half. On the way, third down. marching down the field and taking their time. Carr's got it in the gun. He's looking to the right here on this throw. The Dolphins will punt it. The Dolphins had a fourth down play coming up, but want to be sure about what they burn a timeout. And this will be from 47 yards, the field goal attempt. The field goal attempt is good. It's good.
That was a good hold, good kick, 3 points. Good job by the offense.
The Bills are ready to return the kickoff. Catches it at the 9 and starts his return. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. The Bills will begin their drive from the 26 now. Ellington is in the backfield. First down and 10. And he's forced to the ground.
Good job by the defense. They disguised that blitz. They waited, and they timed it perfectly. And the quarterback not able to make the pass protection change. And not being able to make that pass protection change, well, ends up in a sack for the defense.
As Watkins, he's brought to a halt. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Hurry up, 2-minute offense. He makes the catch. Gains 14.
What's the old expression? Just move the chains. That's what they did with that throw and catch that time, Jim. It also gives them a chance for 3 more downs.
First down at the 35. He'll throw it over the middle. On the money. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line. The Bills are going to burn the first of their 3 timeouts right here. We're back, and the offense is ready to roll after the timeout. Quarters formation here for the defense. Griffin from the gun, trying to work that left side.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than 7, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
They send the tight end in motion. First and 10. Griffin's going to slide. That'll end the play. The Bills elect to take a timeout here before the second down snap. Coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a 3rd time. In on the tackle. Line up now on 3rd down. They were very good at converting these situations a week ago. Offense lines up here. RG3 from the gun. Then picks up about 3.
You need a lot of variety when you get down here in the game. You're losing. You're close to the goal line. You've got to catch the defense by surprise. Can't wait to see this play call.
The field goal try. Yes, sir. That does it for the first half. Bills trail in this one.
All right, welcome to the Verizon Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Dolphins haven't had the same success as last week through the air. The Bills have obviously played a role in that, as they've done what they've needed to in order to slow that part of the game down. So that's it for us at the EA Sports Studio. We'll go back now to Sun Life Stadium for the start of the second half.
And he'll start his return. Him covered up and bring him down inside of the 15. First down coming up. Coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a 3rd time. The 3rd quarter begins with this play. Good piece of tackling.
Ellington's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Offense lines up here. Second down and 8. Ellington's going to secure the handoff.
I think, Jim, you know, when you got a close game like this, it's third and long on the offensive side, you got to be smart. You know, don't take a chance. If you take a chance and cause a turnover, then that could turn the game around big time. So I expect the quarterback here to be very conservative with his decision.
But it's incomplete.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
We'll see what he can do here. And at the 37, he'll be brought down. The Dolphins getting set now for their next series. Lynch is in the backfield. First down at the 37. Takes it on the draw. Smith's there that time for the tackle. The Dolphins have frustrated opponents all season running the football. They've been almost unstoppable. Lynch has been a threat on the ground and continues to rack up yardage.
Been tremendous once again today. And look, let's look at this running back. He's got legs of steel. He can break tackles. He can run around you. That's why this running game is so good. What a beautiful long run by the running back. Once again, he just proves why he's one of the best in the NFL. He's in the top 10 so far this year.
Carr set, empty backfield. Carr's gonna take the snap from the shotgun. This offense can't be stopped on third down, no matter the distance.
Keep the momentum on your side. You got a lead here in the second half. Nice play that time. You pick up the first down. Let's see if you can take advantage of it.
First down at the 47. A.J. Green with the catch. Green's tackled down at the 15.
When you play man-to-man against this receiver, you're going to have a tough time. Quarterback's a good thrower. Really hard for a defensive back to stay with him.
That ball has been picked off. It'll be a touchback.
This defensive coordinator, he is one aggressive dude. He keeps going after this offense, and finally he gets the interception inside their own 20-yard line and stops the offense from getting any points.
First and 10. Ellington's taking the handoff. Robeson's in on the tackle.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game.
Griffin in the shotgun formation. Throws to the right. That pass well defended. The offense needs 9 here on third down after that incompletion. Third and 9 is the call. Griffin from the gun. With 2 hands, he has it. And he's tackled, but not until he picked up the first down.
The Bills look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Down a couple points here in the second half. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
He'll go down. That brings the play to an end.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short game.
Coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Second down and 7. Makes the play.
Well, I think we all know the situation here. It's a close game in the second half, and you're losing, but you pick up a first down. Oh, my gosh, that opens up many more possibilities, what you can do on the offensive side. Good job by the offense.
Handoff by Griffin.
If you want to run the football to success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Second and 9. Ellington's handed the football. They'll mark him at the 34. This will be the 8th play of this drive. The Bills have it at the 34. just had to avoid the sack. Incomplete.
This is what separates offensive lines in the NFL in obvious passing situations like this one on third down. Can you hold up and protect your quarterback to give him time to make those throws? Well, the answer to this one right now is no.
It's going to be a false start call on the offense.
False start offense.
And now, getting set for a 56-yard field goal. The kick, and it's through there. The kick is good.
Well, when you get points, it's never a bad thing. That is for sure. Good job by the field goal kicker that time. Nice job by the offense moving the football down the field.
And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. First down on the way. Lynch is lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. He's tackled right at the 24.
If you're going to be in the top 10 in rushing yards for the season, you got to get big gains. And once again, we see a big gain by this running back who has it all.
The Dolphins take it from the 23. Tackled down at the 28-yard line.
Definitely not surprised to see this running back get another long run. My gosh, he's been doing it all year long. So far this year, he's in the top 10 in rushing yards, and looks like he's going to stay there.
Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield, throws the pass. Another third down conversion. The offense continues to come through in the clutch.
A lot of people talk about time of possession. Sometimes it's overblown, but in a situation like this, where you're winning a close game in the second half, you want to control the tempo, control the clock, keep getting those first downs.
Second down here. Cars lined up, empty backfield, out of the shotgun. They're going to get him here for a sack.
Well, when you see the defense is going to blitz and you can't pick it up, as a quarterback, you've got to change the pass protection. Remember, protect yourself at all times. He didn't do it, so he goes down.
It's third and 15 here after the sack. The Dolphins lined up. Everybody split out wide. Here is the first snap of the final quarter. Smith nearly had the interception. Looking ahead, the Dolphins will be on the road in Denver next week, while the Bills will be playing at home next week. Here's the punt by Maste. Better be careful here. Terrible starting field position here for the offense. Lined up as the single back. Now first and 10. Here's the handoff and picks up maybe 3 or 4.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second and 6. In on the stop. See what they do on this third down situation. Offense lines up here. And Davis is going to take the handoff now. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The Dolphins lead right now, and you look at how they played against the run today, and you have to see that this is a big factor why, Phil.
Yeah, they've done everything right to stop the running game, Jim. What have they done? They've shown a lot of toughness. They have good speed on the defensive side. They're aggressive. But most of all, they've shown tremendous discipline.
Fields it cleanly and starts his return. A dives in on the tackle.
Very lucky that time on that punt return. The coverage was outstanding, and the returner's just lucky he didn't fumble the football.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. First down at the 48. He's tackled right at the 48.
There's nothing like big running plays for an offense. It just makes the offensive lineman feel powerful, gives great confidence to the play caller. There's a reason why this guy's in the top 10 rushing yards so far this season.
Intercepted! He stacked up at that point. Rodgers still down, so we'll take a quick break and be back in just a moment. Nickel formation here for the defense. First down and 10. Ellington on the screen. Taken down at the 45.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
Second and short. Begin. Good work by the defense. This will be a loss of 3. It'll be third down. Coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a 3rd time. The defense gets a sack.
Well, it's a game of chances in the NFL. It's 3rd down. The defensive coordinator said, let's get after this quarterback. He sends the extra guys. He blitzes him, and they get there before the quarterback can react.
Heat's churning ahead. And a dive's there to take him down. The Dolphins bring their offense back onto the field for their next drive. First down at the 34. Gets the handle here. And he's brought to the ground.
Another big day for the running back. He came into today's game in the top 10 in the NFL rushing yards. And he's just adding to those yards. Nice run.
Tackles made.
What a beautiful long run by the running back. Once again, he just proves why he's one of the best in the NFL. He's in the top 10 so far this year.
Carr's going to take it from the gun. Green's got it. And a first.
Quarterback that time realized it was zone coverage. He just waited for the defense to get out of position, and he threw it to the open hole.
First down at the 40. Getting away from the pressure.
It's away from the stack.
And that's a gain of 13. They come to the line, and it's first down. Lynch is in the backfield. They'll go ground. And that's Kruger in on the stop.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
They'll take the snap from inside the red zone. A week ago, they had a lot of success inside the 20. Tight end in motion, trying to beat the play clock. They feed it to him one more time. He's brought down at the 20-yard line.
If you're going to be in the top 10 in rushing yards in the season, you've got to get big gains. And once again, we see a big gain by this running back who has it all.
And now we reach the 2-minute warning. Third down following the run. Offense lines up here. Spins away from contact. Can't find space, and this will be a loss of 1 on the play. This will be a 38-yard field goal attempt. The kick is good.
Again, they get the field goal at that time, and it keeps the momentum on their side. It's positive energy. It makes you feel good. Now we'll see if the defense can carry it on.
Smartly takes the knee in the end zone. First down. Let's see what they come up with here. They come out in the dime package. First down at the 20. They go draw. Gains about 3. The Bills are down on the scoreboard, and this running game is a big reason why. Ellington's been shut down from his very first carry on.
No balance by this offense, like you said today. They can't run the football, but I've said this all the time. It's not always about just dominating physically and blocking up front. Running backs have to do their part. They have to make good decisions, and they got to break some tackles.
The Bills take it from the 23.
Going deep.
Ball's incomplete. Fourth down coming up. Looks like we'll go three and out on this series.
If you're defensive back in the NFL now, you've got to be alert for the deep passes down the field, because not only do you got to play it well, you got to make sure you don't have pass interference.
The Bills take it from the 23. Brings it into his body. He's brought down. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. Here's the first snap after the big play. RG3 from the gun. The pass is incomplete. There was no one open.
Quarterbacks love to see a receiver have this type of play. Even though he doesn't make the catch, the effort is outstanding, and he's given everything he has to make that catch.
Wide receivers are bunched up. Griffin standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. And he's taken down. Third and long, a big spot here as they trail late. Timeout won't be used here. They'll go to the hurry. The Bills from the 37. Fights through that hit. Could have been intercepted. Fourth down is on the way, and to the surprise of no one in this stadium, they're going for it.
Yep, and you know who's going to win this battle? The toughest, most physical team. That's what the NFL is all about.
Griffin's back in shotgun formation. Airing it out. That's a failed conversion, but you might as well look at it like a turnover. It's going back the other way. The Dolphins defense says, no, sir, you are not converting here on fourth down and getting your team back into the game.
Anytime it's a fourth down play, the defensive players, they get so excited because they just feel like the game is on the line. Could have been the game right there. Nice job on the defensive side.
That's second down coming up. Nickel formation for the defense here. Takes the knee. Third down. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Takes the knee.
So that's going to do it, ladies and gentlemen, for this game. Dolphins win 13-6. It was an ugly win. A lot of running. The Bills have a good secondary, and it was proven. They picked Derek Carr off twice. Running the ball seemed like the more opportunistic strategy, honestly. It worked out. Marshawn Lynch and the Dolphins take the win. So we'll move on to week 12 now as we inch ever closer to the playoffs. The Dolphins trying to make sure that they make it in. The Bills just playing for respect and not really getting it in this game. Players were hurt on some hits that, you know, you'd expect in a divisional matchup. So we'll move forward. We'll check the results of all the games from this week, including Houston and Texans. Houston and Cleveland. Couldn't speak there. So we'll move forward. I don't know what game we're going to do next. We'll have to look at what we have in week 12, what's available to us. I don't know yet. We'll see. Maybe Denver. Maybe whoever Denver plays. As you see, can see, the Ravens are 5-5 after a bye week. All right. That actually ought to be a good game. Offensively, the Ravens are first in the league. What do we got here? Week 11. Dolphins defeat the Bills 13-6. We saw that. Chicago. Wow. Houston defeats Cleveland. Wow. All right. Packers defeat the Eagles. Kansas City is defeated by the Seahawks. Carolina is beat by the Falcons. New Orleans defeats Bengals. Washington beats Tampa. St. Louis over Denver. San Fran over the Giants. San Diego destroys Oakland. Detroit defeats Arizona. New England beats Indy. Pittsburgh takes down Tennessee. So, as you saw, both of the two AFC North teams lost. One team won. The Bengals have actually fallen. I don't know if you guys caught that in time, but the Bengals have fallen. The Browns are no longer first in the conference. The Broncos are. And making moves up through the divisions are now the Pittsburgh Steelers, who I believe might have to play Cleveland once more. I believe Cleveland has played... No, Pittsburgh doesn't have to play Cleveland anymore. Pittsburgh's already beat them. Baltimore has to play Cleveland one last time. Baltimore can move to 3-3 on the year in the division, which would probably make them extremely thrilled. So we will see that game. Pittsburgh has two more games on the schedule. Both against Cincinnati, I'm assuming. Based on the fact that they've already played the Ravens twice and the Browns twice. So we'll see where that goes. That division is now getting even more interesting. Just for the simple fact that you have Cleveland at 7-3, Pittsburgh 6-5, and Baltimore's 5-5. Pittsburgh still hasn't had their bye week. I'm guessing that they have it this week, week 11. I believe it's the final week for bye weeks. I could be wrong on that, but either way, we'll see what happens. AFC South, Jaguars move even further ahead. Actually, not really. The Texans are only a game behind. Texans with a chance at getting to their divisional. Or winning their division now. Colts kind of looking like they're out of it. Possibly, we all know the story with the Titans. In the AFC East, the Dolphins take the lead back in the division, defeating the Bills, giving them a better divisional record than the Jets at that point. So therefore, they take the lead back at 6-4 and 6-4. Patriots are actually almost still in this because of the fact that both teams only have 6 wins. It's very possible. That's the only way they're getting in the playoffs. And out west, you have the Broncos, Chargers, Raiders, and Chiefs. Every single last one of them have a chance at the division. Probably now moving to the most even division in the league. Broncos obviously holding top spot, but that also being that possibly one of these 6-4 teams right here could get in as a wild card. So we'll see what happens there. In the NFC side of the ball, you do have the Vikings at 8-2. The Lions have won their last two games, moving to 6-4 and putting themselves back into the divisional race. In the NFC South, you continue to have the 6-4 Saints, the 6-5 Panthers, 4-6 Bucks, and the Falcons, who are out of it, as well as pretty much the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. You're looking at these two teams, more than likely Tampa. Just, I don't know, it's Tampa. In the East, Giants, Cowboys continue to be the two teams to beat. Redskins have a chance. I'm thinking the Eagles are probably out of it. And out West, it's all Rams. It's all Rams. I'm thinking the Rams are going to lock this up pretty soon for their division. Not really much of a change there. So we'll take a look at the schedule, see what game we're going to do for week 12, and we'll move on as we get another week closer to the NFL playoffs. So we have Chiefs at Raiders, which is enticing. Browns at Falcons, not really. Well, I did say Broncos. It's not going to be Broncos because they are playing the Dolphins again. We've already done this game once this year. Really, the only one I wanted to do twice was Steelers and Ravens, we didn't even do that, so we're going to avoid from doing that. Right now, it's kind of looking like it's Chiefs at Raiders, honestly. You know what? No, we're going to do Lions at Patriots. Just because I want to have some fun. I enjoyed playing as Peyton Manning, even though he is in New England. I enjoyed it. I look forward to playing as Peyton in the Patriots again. So, Ravens get ready to play the Saints. And we will get ready for the Patriots game. So, thank you guys so much for joining us. I hope you guys enjoyed this game. And I'll see you next time.